is 4 minutes. I'm going to be a little fast so that at least I can cover most of the most important highlights of the program. But I want to use 1 minute, first of all, to thank you, Mr. Robert Kaushenga, for such an important forum. When I look through, 90% of the population here are young people. And to me, this is a great opportunity for information sharing. These are some of the forums which are very rare, like you said before. Sometimes people and institutions pay a lot to have these forums take place. And also for the partners who have really supported to ensure that this Pakasa Forum is indeed taking place. And also the theme, entrepreneurship. Entrepreneurship is one of the options in addressing unemployment, and it's one of the major options, I would say. I'll talk about the current Youth Livelihood Program, which is a program that is going to be implemented by the Ministry of Gender, Labor and Social Development together with the youth leadership in Uganda. That is the National Youth Council, which is the governing structure for the young people in Uganda. I'm sure with the structures from national, district, sub-county, parish, up to the villages. This program, a little background of it, comes in after a study which has been made. We're seeing the challenges that, first of all, were faced, especially in the previous capital venture fund, which most of you, which the public is aware of. This is a program which was being implemented by the Ministry of Finance, where funds were sent to different commercial banks for young people to be able to access these funds. However, there were a lot of challenges that most of the commercial banks made it very difficult for the young people to access these funds. And on some of the challenges which we highlighted, like for example, young people don't have collateral security, the interest rate sometimes it's very high for the businesses that are starting up. The intention of government was to support even startups. And first of all, banks don't support startups. It was quite a challenge. They asked for guarantors as an option, but a guarantor meant he had to have collateral. And even some of the other stringent conditions which we really had, asking young people to come with bills of electricity bills which have their names. You need to have a tenant agreement to prove that. How many of our young people have some of this? It was really hard. And also accessibility was quite a big problem. I will give you an example. Somebody from Karamoja, the only bank you can access is to go up to Mbale. So it was quite a big challenge, and that's why the option, after started looking at even what from the young people themselves over the country and seeing how the program was moving, now government took a step this financial year and allocated 256 billion Uganda shillings to boost the livelihoods of the young people. And one, addressing the following issue, accessibility, first of all. Now, this time round, the funds are no longer in the banks. Funds have been sent to all sub-counties in Uganda. In Kampala, the divisions. And the other part of it, it's a community-driven program. And also, the issue of collateral is no longer an issue. We don't need collateral for this. The fund itself, it's interest fee if a young person can pay back within 1 year. If you go beyond 1 year to the maximum of 3 years, then there is a 5% interest to cover for the inflation gap. And the other difference about these funds, you don't need guarantors, as in somebody who's going to be able to pay back the money. No. The guarantor in this place, we need someone in a good, someone with a reputation in the community that says, I know this young person, he comes from this place, he comes from here.
Somebody like me.
Yes. You can guarantee, but it's not guaranteed that you're going to pay back the money, but at least to say, we know this young person, he works here, so that we don't get many people who are known. The other part of it, you only need the following. One, you need two things. You need to prove that you're a young person between the age of 18 and 30. Second, you need to prove that you're a Ugandan, and that's all. The other important part that I should mention, this fund is not limited to enterprises. As long as the enterprise you're presenting has a business sense and you can be able to prove that I can be able to make out money out of this, I can be able to make out profits, it's not limited. The other important question I'm sure we can interact, especially when you're asking questions, is this time round, this fund is not going to individuals for a start. It is going to groups. Reason, the groups will, the members of the group will be the guarantors. You're the one to guarantee yourself. And we are starting with groups of 10 to 12. Reason being, you don't need to be all of you in one enterprise. One can be in Boda Boda, the other in mobile money and other things.
Okay.
I think we can interact other things when I get a lot of questions. Thank you.
You have 1 minute and I want you to answer this question.
Yep.
When can people go and get their money? Where can people go and get the money? How much can somebody ask for? Is there a maximum limit or a lower limit? Can Pakasa register people and send them to you to give them money?
I'll start with the where question. There are two offices. Like I said, right now what you need is you need to know where the offices of your sub-county where you're coming from. That's all. And look for the following people. The community development officer, the accounting officer who are the chiefs in the community sub-counties. If it is Kampala, you look for the town clerk. And also, we have youth participation. You look for the chairperson for the youth in the sub-county or if it's here in Kampala for the division. All these names and information is going to be put in newspapers so that people can be able to access them. The offices at national, one, the Ministry of Gender, Labor and Social Development. It's on Simbamanyo House, just behind Central Police Station. And the National Youth Council offices, we are allocated in Intinda, on Matters Way, just near UNEB offices. You just see the poster, you turn. The other question you asked was how much someone can access. For a start, it's between 10 to 12 million Uganda shillings. Unless, if there will be some special cases, if the business really proves that it can even take 20 million, then the committees will be able to take on that, but those will be special cases. However, the other question was where?
When?
I would say this program started in August this year when the ministry.
No, last year.
Last year, sorry.
We're in 2014.
I meant this financial year. I meant this financial year, which is last year in October, when government was putting in place an institutional framework where you can be able to go. Okay. Yesterday the program was launched. It means by the end of Feb, funds will be already in the districts.
So
and young people can access it.
You, Mr. Kavuma, National Chairman of the National Youth Council, in the presence of about 2,000 to 3,000 people at Kampala Parents School on national TV, you guarantee us that February end, the money will be there.
Yes. I want to put this clear.
And if it's not there, you will go to hell.
Yeah,
you die.
I'm sure this is not the only forum in Pakasa. Next time I'll come back to tell a testimony.
Right.
And we shall have a lot of young people to testify on this.
Okay.
These funds, every year, government's allocating 53 billion Uganda shillings. That is starting with the next financial year. But for this financial year, they allocated 19 billion Uganda shillings because the program came in even after the budget was read, remember? So with the 19 billion, we are going to start with a significant number of districts, which is not all the 112. However, the selection process, the training of these young people is going to be starting in all the districts. And this time around, it's not workshop trainings. If you're mechanics, and you need to have training in a garage, and then you're given what you need to set up. So it's going to be a community driven program. You just need to get to all these offices. You need to get some of this program and see on how best you can take it on.
Okay. If any of these people let you down, call me. Thank you very much. I am not going to take questions at this time because we will have another question and answer session. So I'll let you go, but don't leave the place because people will be asking questions. Because I want to invite on the stage people who have actually benefited from these programs at UIRI, at KCCA, and at Kurant, to tell us how this has worked for them, so that seeing, as I know you Africans, seeing is believing. So I want to bring here people who have actually done it. And before we leave, there are people under those tents. Take their information, ask them, find out where this will happen. And I am not letting Kavuma go. At the end, he will stay here and answer any lingering questions that you have. Are we agreed on that? Maybe before Kavuma leaves, I will request that you give him 2 minutes to explain the fund in Luganda. Unless my Luganda is better than yours. Is yours better than mine? Please explain, because this is so important for many people who are not here and are out there and want to understand where this money is. Try.
Nyanza nyosero. Ensonga jenyonyako ye ensonga za sente za bavubuka. Sente za bavubuka zino tuzimanyi nti emabegeri emyaka ebiri egyatandika. The sente government is aware za mu banks zino ze banks za fe, Stanbic Banks, Ntinari Bank. Ne buzibu twafunamu nti obukwakulizo bwali buzibu nnyo okusobozesa abavubuka okufuna ensimbi zino. N'olw'ensonga eyo guno mwaka gw'ebyensimbi gwe tulimu, government n'esalawo ensimbi zino ezijjeyo mu banks kati zijjire ddala mu bavubuka, era nga ensimbi zino zigenda kusangibwa ku magombolola gaffe gye tuva mu disitulikiti zonna ezitwala Uganda 10-12, nga ebyetaago bigenda kuba nga bisobozesa omuvubuka okusobola okufuna ensimbi zino okubaako kyatandika. Kye njagala okuba omulanga, abavubuka sente si zaakulya, sente za kukola mirimu, ate sente za kwewola okuzizzaayo. Sente zino tezigenda kubeerako interest oba amagoba gonna, kasita oba nga omuvubuka osobola ozikomyawo mu mwaka gumu. Kasita osukka mu mwaka ogumu naye ekkomo lya myaka esatu. Kiba kitegeeza bagenda kuwa ogenda kuleeta interest okinandisa amagoba ga 5% oba 5-10%, ezo ze wakola ki? Ze wasaba. Ensimbi zino zigenda kuweebwa groups z'abavubuka. Kyemwetaaga kyokka kuleeta bukakafu nti oli muvubuka wakati w'emyaka 18-3. Constitution bwetugamba oye muvubuka mu Uganda. 18-3 constitution ya Uganda. 35 is Africa Youth Charter, but the Ugandan constitution is 18-30. Ekyokubiri, olina okubeera n'obukakafu nti oli munnayuganda. Ebyetaagisa kwekyo tubimanyi, olina okubeera ng'olina either voters card, oyinza ogenda n'oswearing affidavit oba mu kkooti, naye olina okubeera n'obukakafu obwo. Ekirala, ensimbi zino tetwetaaga musingo gwonna. Tetwetaaga musingo gwonna, kyetwetaaga bavubuka mu groups. Omuntu kino omu yetaaga nafuna sente okutandika, tunatandika na group olw'ensonga. Munoonya. Ekirala, obukulembeze bw'abavubuka okutandikira ku district ne ku sub-county bugenda kubeera ku bukiiko obwo bugenda okulondoola ensimbi zino. Nti omuvubuka kyeyetaaga kumanya mukulembeze wange mu division ene ya Kampala y'ani. Naye amanya tugenda bakukabawa ne contacts zaabwe. Offices zaffe ez'abavubuka zisangibwa Ntinda kumpi ne ofiisi ya ekitongole ekikola ku bibuuzo kitoyisa NEB oba ministry ey'abavubuka ku ministry of gender, oba genda mu district yonna kugombolola onoonye omuntu akola ku nsonga z'abavubuka bayita ba CDO esawa yakati bonna balina information, oba ku district ne bonoonya kawo oba gwe twandise chief administration officer be bantu abakola ku nteekateeka eno z'ensimbi z'abavubuka. Mwebale nnyo beddala.
Ukyali wano tolina gy'olaga, abalina ebibuuzo babikuleetera wano. Ate kye nsazeewo nze nga mukama wa bukende ne TV endala zonna ezisinga wano mu Uganda nze mukama wa TV wano mu Uganda ngenda kuyita ojonyonyole sente z'abaana owulimbe mwebale nnyo. Thank you very much. So let's give them a round of applause as they resume their seats. Right. I have the privilege of hosting the following people because they have achieved a great deal as young people, highly recognized because of gaining from what we're talking about. First is Lovin Kobusinje. I know some of you mix up my name. There's a difference between Kabushenga and Kobusinje. So you're going to see it today. You see what she looks like? They look like Kabushenga. So, Lovin, you're welcome. Please take a seat next to me here. The next one is Michael Mubiru from Chevando Tusobola Youth Initiative. Makes briquettes. Michael Mubiru was supported by Kampala Capital City Authority, KCCA. UIRI supported Lovin Kobusinze in her business. I'm not going to tell you what businesses they are. Lovin, as you see, is a very rich woman right now. Richer than me. Not that I am rich. Dennis Kasule, who was an incubatee at Kurat, and he has come with his products, so I'm going to test. Then we have Andrew Mupuya, I hope he's around, who is a young entrepreneur, makes paper bags and envelopes. Is Andrew here? Oh yeah, Andrew, were you the one who was on CNN? Yes. So I don't know, even me, I haven't reached CNN yet. I don't know when you will reach there, but Andrew, who is coming, has been featured on CNN for his business. He's been made the young entrepreneur of the year. So please welcome people who have powerful stories to share with you. You can take the throne now that you are the king of enterprise in Uganda. I don't know how many of you... Yes, I also have another young lady, Merab Manige, who processes porridge and soup from mushrooms. I think now I have to give way because the bosses have arrived, so you better sit here. In the Bible, they say the first shall be last and the last shall be first. So I want to start with you, Merab. Many years I have been drinking three types of porridge: millet, sorghum, and maize. I had never heard of mushrooms. Tell me the story.
Thank you very much, the organizers of Pakasa Forum. The mushroom porridge is quite a unique product. Like any other entrepreneur, you should have an innovative mind. So I innovated the mushroom porridge. After doing product development and formulation with Uganda Industrial Research Institute, I put the taste of the soup on the market. And when I was doing the sensory evaluation, I realized that the soup is for a certain class of people. And I was like, why can't I look for a unique product that is used to almost all people? What came into my mind was porridge. As you've said, there are only millet, rice, maybe sorghum porridge, and maize on the market. But I was like, if I incorporated the mushrooms in these porridges, how would the taste be? I came up with a formula, and to tell you, it's very good, tasty, and delicious.
First, give me mine. It pays to be here. But people are wondering, yes, you have a good product. How did you start? Who supported you? How did it come to the market?
Starting was quite challenging You know, coming up with a new idea is not easy. At first I was into Irish selling, because we have a lot of it in Cabaret. I went into Irish business, but to LED it was challenging. Most of those drivers would put you on top of a lorry coming from Cabaret to Kampala, and it was not good for LED. I thought of what I would do to substitute the Irish business. The fact that I had a background of forestry and agriculture, I went back into my books, though most of it was theory. I landed on the mushroom nuts. I was like, if I converted these nuts into practical, would it help me? Yes. Though it was challenging, you know, converting theory into practical is very, very challenging. But I did it, and I saw the mushroom started coming out. People started contacting me, those that would take the samples for testing. They were like, can you train us, can you train us? And I started from that being a trainer. I've actually trained over 10,000 people in mushroom growing, and I give that a credit as indirect employment. Yes.
When is your next class for mushroom growing training so I can attend?
When you need a mushroom training as a lecturer, we don't put a specific date, but if you get interested, you get in touch with us and we organize a date. We can do it directly from your place because it is done from your home. Mushrooms do not require land. We just need a small space. So the youth who are saying you're out of agriculture because of no land, no. There are other things you can do like mushroom. No land, but any small space you have. We can guide you and hope you have mushroom gardens as your place.
Loving, you're quiet but sitting on a fortune. How did you find out about UIRI and how did you get there? And how did that help you? That is the puzzle on, and yet you look so young. So how did you manage it?
Thank you, Bo. I'm called Lovin Kosinje, as you've heard. I came to know about Uganda Industrial Research Institute while I was in the bank somewhere in Kampala. As I was talking to the loans officer because I wanted to start business, he told me, you have a nice idea, because I was trying to explain my idea to him. If you go to Uganda Industrial Research Institute, they help you. I didn't know where it was. I didn't know anybody there. I asked, where is that institute? And then he told me it is based in Nakawa, next to opposite Chambogo University. So I went there for the first time. I inquired from the information desk, and from that moment, they helped me with the necessary information, and that is where.
What business do you do? What business did you take to Uganda Industrial Research Institute?
When I went to Uganda Industrial Research Institute, I told them I work with fish farmers, and they are faced with the challenge of marketing their fish. I want to introduce a fish sausage so that I can reduce the market challenge.
And fish sausages?
Yes, please.
Go on.
So when I told them about the fish sausage, the first question was, where is the fish? I said, the fish is with me because I work with the farmers. Do you think you have enough fish to supply, to get enough raw material? I said I have over 500 farmers, and I am sure I'll make it.
How much money are you making from fish sausages? Tell the truth.
Fish sausages, a kilo is 20,000 Uganda shillings. And on a week, you can sell 1,000 kilos, so that is about 20 million Uganda shillings per week.
You're making 20 million shillings per week. I'm going to talk to my board. I need to change jobs. Dennis, Where did you find Segawa and how did he help?
Where did I find Segawa?
Exactly, because everybody's sitting here. Why is it you, who only you who knew about him? How come all these other people didn't know about him?
Well, first of all, I want to thank the Lord that I'm in this place. That is number one.
Mm-hmm.
I've been an entrepreneur all my life.
Okay.
In fact, I'll tell a joke of my
entrepreneurship. You're very young. You're not old.
When I was in school, I used to make double grab.
What does that mean?
I used to make the corn for myself, fry it, and then also make corn for other students. So
you were selling corn in school?
No, that is not the way I did it. So I would consume mine, and when I finished it, when everybody is in Kau, I would lend people corn. Then the next term, they bring me pocket money.
How intelligent. Why didn't I think of that when I was in school? So you've been a businessman since school?
Exactly.
And government didn't help you with that at all?
I helped myself, first of all.
Yep.
I started in the kitchen. I was in my second year. I did a lot of businesses. I did bricklaying. It didn't work out. I tried to do some ice cream. It was very expensive. People did not understand the quality I was giving them. When I was in my second year at the university, I offered food science and technology. They taught me some food science, and this is how I developed juice. I started by selling to the sick people in Butabika Hospital. I had an aunt there, and she was working in the welfare, and I was packaging in those ice cream tins, if you have seen in the supermarkets. Then when I finished my degree, the dean of students invited me to work in the labs to start producing this juice, and I started producing from food science and technology. That was 2010. In 2011 is when I met with Mr. Segawa, and we met outside Churad. I was asking him to link me to the major supermarkets. You know, they're not easy to go into.
Yeah.
So this is how I meet with Mr. Segawa. Mm-hmm. And when he joined Churad, I already knew him.
What did he do for you at Churad? How did he help you? What did Churad do for you?
Well, Churad, I was packaging in boxes, and they're very expensive.
Yes.
And I needed to put my product in that shrink wrap right there.
Okay.
And they provided me with the technical support where I can get the shrink wrap, and also with the funding to do that.
Okay, so which means this one also is mine. Put it here.
That should be a small check.
Yeah, yeah. No. That's why you're here. So this is payment for you being here. Michael.
Yes, please.
I'm told you've made a fortune with the support of KCCA. One, why you and not other people? How did you get there? And what is it that they're doing for you?
I am Mubiru Michael, and I'm here to represent an organization called Chevando Tusobola Youth Initiative Africa. Our organization basically focuses on bringing together the youth and the general community by promoting employment opportunities through advocacy on health, sanitation, and environmental protection. Our main project is briquette making, and we are located in Chevando.
What are briquettes?
Briquette is a burning substance,
mm-hmm,
that you can use to cook food, just like the normal charcoal.
Okay, so yeah. How did you link up with KCCA and how did they help you?
Actually, KCCA has done a lot in supporting.
How is the
in
question?
Supporting us. We received 5 million through a program called Community Development. That is CDD.
How much?
5 million.
Through which program?
It is called Community Driven Development, CDD. It was designed to benefit the young people,
mm-hmm,
Throughout Kampala,
yes,
I am a testimony.
So any young people can go to KCCA, community development, and get 5 million shillings?
Yes.
What are the conditions? I mean, what conditions did you meet in order to qualify?
What I did was to initially, the organization was not registered.
Okay.
I had to take it for registration, and now it is registered for, okay. It has now lasted for three and a half years.
How many members are you?
This organization is composed of 30 members, of which 17 are female and 13 are male.
How many are women?
Women are 17 and the males are 13. So we are composed of 30 members.
So how come you, the man, is the leader of the group if the women are in the majority? How did you make it?
Sorry.
Okay, let me move on to another question. How much money are you making from your business?
Each month, we are making 500,000.
Per month? 500,000 per month?
Yeah, 500,000 per month. We nearly produce a ton. Okay. That is like 800 to 900 kilograms.
Okay.
Yeah, that is because we don't have enough machines. That is motorized machines that can help us to increase our production.
Now, you go with your group to Kavuma. Kavuma has money. He's around.
Kavuma, I'm coming, Kavuma.
Uh-huh. Dennis, I didn't ask you, how much money are you making?
Well, I almost thought you had forgotten.
No. It's just that I'd taken my things, so I was...
We make 41 cartons every 3 times a week.
Okay.
And we make about 6 million a month.
Not bad for a young man. Without too many responsibilities, considering you are selling corn for much less. So, Andrew, international superstar, young entrepreneur, tell me about your business and how did you get there?
My business is an eco-friendly venture of making paper bags. I started this out 5 years back. When I was in high school, I was here at college, yes. And then by that time, the government proposed to ban use of the polythene bags in the country. Mm-hmm. But however, they didn't implement the idea because there was no ready replacement for it.
Okay.
So it gave me an idea of how could I, what could be the better replacement. Mm-hmm. And that's how I started up. And I started with a capital of 36,000 in Uganda.
First go back. You started with a capital of how much?
36,000.
36,000 shillings.
Yes.
What's the value of your business now?
Oh, $1.5 million.
I think we should just go home. How did you do that?
Sorry?
How did you do that? How did you grow your business? What is it that you did?
What I did can also be done by anyone else. Because
No. You're a superman.
No.
Tell me, explain how an ordinary person sitting in that audience using 36,000 shillings can build a $1.5 million business. By the way, are you a university graduate?
I'm left with one semester.
You are where?
I'm still at campus.
I've run out of words because just when I think I am the most inspirational person in the world, I run into people like Andrew. So you're still on campus?
Yes.
What are you studying?
A Bachelor of Commerce.
Bachelor of Commerce. So soon you'll be a multimillionaire in Uganda. So you explain to people listening and watching how you managed to do this.
I started up this business, but it was crucial. It was a very new venture because I won't tell you that there was somewhere where I could look through that this is a person who is doing the same venture. Let me do what he or she is doing. So, My markets were quite new because people who were using the polythene bags were the ones I had to convince to buy the paper bags. My first clients was, one of them was the former Pele supermarket just across here. It's now replaced by Nakumat. So I had to start. I didn't have any money when I was starting the business, but I had an idea. So when I approached the market, they told me, what are you looking after? So they requested for the sample. And then I made the sample and I took it to them. And they gave me a new order. And they wanted, my first client wanted 100 bags within a day. But I didn't have the capital to start. I didn't have even zero seed. I was on zero seedings to start the business.
Yeah.
But I was given the order.
Of 36,000 shillings?
36,000 was my budget. That was my plan.
Yes.
Yes. So I collected used plastic bottles, and then I sold them to a recycling plant.
Okay.
And I was able to get 28,000 Uganda shillings. And then I also borrowed part of it from my teacher, the balance of 8,000 shillings.
And you started supply?
Yes, and I started off. My first turn, I made a profit of 20,000, of which I plowed back into the business. Then time went on, I had to employ my fellow students.
So you are an employer now?
Yes.
Do you have a job for me?
Yes, so that's how I went on. Time came, I had to go out of school. I started employing outside the people. And it was all about having a vision. I had a vision that I'm supposed to achieve, and I believe I've not even achieved it. I'm not even halfway of where I'm supposed to go.
Really?
Yes.
Okay. Can I just ask all of you one favor? Do you think you can tell, in summary, your stories, what you do, what business you do, how you do it in Luganda, however bad your Luganda is? Merab, don't look at me. By the way, I didn't ask you, how much money are you making from...
I process averagely 100 to 150 kilograms of mushroom every week, and a half kilogram of the mushroom porridge goes for 10,000. So averagely we make 15 to 22 million a week.
These are great people. So let me start with you, Dennis. You're a Muganda, with good Luganda. Abantu babulire business yo jokola. Abakura bakuyamba batya ojifuna mu sente meka. Tubabulira amazima tubalimba. Kwenzo kuba okola sente nyingi ateno tugambe ntono. URA is not going to come for you, I can assure you. Please go ahead.
Neyanza nyo mamikopshenga. Okutandika simanyo ba mzee anaulira kastola ko ke nabagambye kuba kati na yala bikali ku TV. Obanka buke.
Hey.
Well, nze obulambo wange bonna mbadde mutandisi wa mirimu era tekibadde kyangu. Natandika n'emitwalo etaano. Mukwano gwange bamuyita Kaweesa Richard, yazimpola nkyali ku university.
Wamusasula?
Njagala nyo Bible. Omanyi Bible egamba nti bononyo bwakabaka bwa Katonda ebirala bikwongerwako. So honesty oba obwesimbu byebimu kubinzimbye. Kangende maso kakati bwe ntandika n'emitwalo egyo etaano
ng'osuubula ki?
Emitwalo etaano?
Wali osuubula ki ku mitwalo etaano? Bizinesi yo gy'osuubula kati osuubula ki?
Emitwalo egyo bale saatandika na juice. Natandika nasooka kuba matafaali ku ttaka lyaffe ery'obujjajja wanebulaga. Amatafaali gaasala nze bannange tegaakola. Ne nva mu matafaali ne ngezaako okukola ebyamata tebyatambula. Kati bwe nali mwaka gwange ogw'okubiri ne ntandika okukola juice.
Omwaka ogw'okubiri wa?
ku University Makerere. Nali njize ya magezi mubye nali nsomye na yenga mbichati amu na ine ntandi kukola Joyce. Natandi kila mchiyungu echa koja wange neje mitu aletano emengo nintandi kukola Joyce nga mpaki nga mbukepe kwa ice cream ngeira mutunza abaradde butabika hospital. Neyo ngeira maso kola mumwaka okuwa nkumi bili mukumi University wena malo kusoma dini nangamba kati ogenda college nemuka ngeenda kusigalanga nkola Joyce nangamba ulina na yu ukulida wainzo kuta watufu nampita ku university mulabu za femwe njini mwetu aso miranga nintandi kukulida mu Joyce. Mumwaka kwa nkumi bili mukumi na gumu nensinka na mwami Apollo Segawa na msinka na wabweru wa Churad netutandika okola business wabweru kati bwabata andika we chibina cha Churad na mazota andika chibina cha Churad na ngamba jangu weno wali opportunity tusobolo kuyamba kukula brisk juice ono gwe mulabye wano esa weno mwami Apollo Churad alimukuntu ala ku leveddako nti ngenda tandiko mukola mubunji kuba ekizibu kyembadde nacho nga juice mbera na mutono nga ate abansaba mamwagala mubunji already waliwo sente zafuniddwa dda era nsubira nti ba customer babere bagumu ekyokunywa bagenda kifuna mu kaseera bwe bakyagalira. Kyekyo kyenyinza okugamba natandika ntya ne kyekyo
bakula ne bakuyambye mu ngeri ki ate business ogifuna mu sente meka
wanje
Segawa akuyambye atya mukola business yo nekirala business gyokola ya juice ogifuna mu sente meka
Sega wanyambye nti weyansangira juice ono nali mu parkinga mu box ate kakati yensevuddeyo abanene bonna bensiona okujja ko gebagaana obuvera ba parkinga mu kaveera nga bwe katyo so anyambye ko okujja juice mu box ne muteeka mu kaveera ne nyongeza ku profit margin.
Sene meka profit margin mu Luganda amagoba nyongeza ku magoba gofunamu
ne nyongeza ku magoba ge mfuna kubika chupa kubali lidali mfuna kachupa kana katono anyizo kafuna ko siringi bibiri na yo rakavera ke nafuna nsobolo kafuna ko siringi nga bibiri mu atano bisatu
akutwalira awamu
okutwalira awamu
kambuze sente zofuna mu juice senemeka
omwezi nsobolo rebitambude moderately bachita bache
kati nga kati embera bweliyo yomusana
nsobolo nkola milioni mukaga
omwezi gumu
omwezi
obwavu wabugoba Michael gwe wayambibwa KCCA
so
business joli mu yachi
business jenkolera delakati ya manda
usubula manda
si subula manda naye nga kola bukozi sigano gebate ko kozesa
sige tuocha
agumuchi agemiti abobono nyenye obutonde naye amanda ge ngamba ge manda gava mu kasasiro oba what you call fibrous material amanda gano mawangazi era amanda gano
kati fenga abafumbi bebi janjalo gamale banga dene
weba lenyo chi amani amanda gano mawangazi era oba wali ogakosezaako marunji dala lero nate singo kozesa kuga
koze bubito tuletedde yo sample kwa bampadde ku sample kati nze ndi bulungi
kubanga ndi ku panel naitidwa wali ku tent ya Februari basobola kugenda ne balaba kiche kigenda maso tutaddewo bano kulaga step 1 mpaka ku Z
ugafuna musene meka
amanda gano bulikire baya 10 tupakinga kubanga gafe gaina definite shape tupakinga obuntu 15 mu kavera etuka siringa tuna kuma ketwagula ka siring machine wetu siringa kaba ready kutwala olina lyo kafumba
kakati omuntu yeno muvubuka abatudde wana abatulaba ku TV ayinza okusitukana agenda mu KCCN bamuyamba obakizibu
mbandiriza abavubuka problem eri wanti okay balemeredwa of putting available resources to usefulness zenga Michael nga sentebe wabavubuka ekyebando nasalawo abavubuka mbakulembere nga nina leadership skills Nenja ne bategeza kino kisobolokola tukungane avuka kirungi bampuliriramu.
Olabi kweyagala kugenda mu parliament.
Ne tubakunganya ne tubabulira ne tujayo receipts ebintu ne bitambula.
Loving, do you want to give it a try? In Luganda. Go ahead, tell us your business, how you started it, how you IRI helped you.
Thank you. In Uganda, it is difficult to start a business. So some of you are there seated, don't be frustrated, just hang on. And if you want to approach Uganda Industrial Research Institute, I can take you there. I approach me and I will take you there.
Oyo gwe mulaba business ye akola sausages abyennyanja azifuna mu miliyoni.
Ezo miliyoni tezibeera zona nti profit.
Aha, anti gwe nyonyole. Zogere kati fetu nasalawo meka ezizo ne banyonyole. Business gyokola ogikola otya, bakuyamba batya, ate ozifuna mu sente meka.
We natandika nali nkola kilo asatu munya. Asatu munya nga
nzikolera wa?
Nga zikolera mu Institute ya Meat Plant, Uganda Industrial Research Institute.
Mm-hmm. Bali bakujjako sente?
Ne sente zali saving zange. Mm-hmm. Nali nina na milioni bili.
Neda chengamba, aba UIRI, bakujjako sente, ukoze save yu mabia.
Tebakujjako sente wa denechiku. It was free of charge. Mm-hmm. And they have trainers who assist you. Mm-hmm. So we started training, and every day I would make 34 kilograms, which was very little to me because I thought maybe I would make 100, 200, but I was in the learning process. So
are you still there at UIRI or you have left?
I am still there. Because I haven't even completed my incubation time.
Yes.
I have just been there now for 2 years. Uh-huh. But I have already attracted an investor in my company from the UK. Uh-huh. So currently we are 3 shareholders. Uh-huh. We have bought our own machinery, and we hope by the end of our incubation period, we are set to move forward.
Kali. Merab, I have sent somebody a message to tell me the name of mushrooms in Luganda. I think I can remember, but I want to be sure. Obutiko. Ono gwemula vono, obutiko abukozemu sente nkumu nyo. Kwe gamba ye obutiko atabu tute wala, abukola mu obuji. Na atunda, nebagula, bantu nebafumba mu obuji. Ayamba n'abaagala okulima obutiko n'abawa ku magezi ngeri ki gye muyinza okubulima. Atugambye wano teweetaaga ttaka wadde inchi emu okulima obutiko, era bwe muba mumaze wano ayinza okubanyonnyola ngeri ki gy'agenda okutuyambamu. Naye mpozi owoolwaleero gwe tuwadde entebe nnene mwami Mupuya, lino Luganda, atunyonnyole bizinesi ye gy'akola gy'agijje, sente ze yateekamu ne sente zaakola kati. Andrew.
Nga we mbagambye lusose natandika n'emitwalo 36 eza Uganda.
Emitwalo 36 abamu bazinywamu bia ekiro kimu n'amala. Kati gwe ssebo ozikozeemu kampuni yenkana etya obunene ate sente mmeka z'okola? Watu okola bizinesi yaki? Looza we tuba tutandikira kikyo osuubula? Kiki kyotunda? Business kigyokola?
Nkola paper bags.
Yeah,
paper bags tusobola okusoloka packaging ebintu ba mu maduuka, mu supermarket, obanga flower packing companies. Yeah. Any form of packaging tuzikola paper bags.
Kampuni yo kati ewera musende mmeka okuva ku 3 ne batandika najo?
Vali ya kampani yange kati erimu mukakadde kamu n'ekitundu eya dola vali yayo.
Emyaka egijo giri emeka?
Myaka 5.
Enedda ngamba gwe kennyini oli wa myaka emeka?
2 mu 2.
ndoza tubiveko tukole ebirale myaka abiri mu ebiri achali makerere mu university asula paper bags yatandika mitwale esatu mukakaga katalina million dollar nekitu. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much. These are our powerful stories today. Mwengenda basigaza wano abebibuzo, where's the my man Dennis? 5-5, 1 minute each.